Not a long time ago, I created a video about how to capture the Milky Way with an iPhone 13 Pro, but that video was in short formats, and because of very positive response, I decided to create like a full tutorial about on how to shoot the Milky Ways and stars with an iPhone 13 Pro. I do apologize in advance for the fact that this video or the majority of these videos and images are in vertical format, but I will try to make as interactive as possible. There is also one thing you're gonna need beside your phone, your iPhone. You're gonna need a tripod and with a mount to mount your phone on the tripod. Without this, you won't be able to take this kind of photographs. You may be able if you place your phone somewhere on straight on a rock or someone inclined, but it's not gonna be absolutely the same. There are a couple of settings you have to do in order to maximize the potential of your camera. First thing, disable the live mode and the flash. You don't need those. Then you'll have to put on 1x camera. That is the camera for low light photography, and that is the camera you will capture the Milky Way, because on 0.5 and on 3x those cameras are not very good for low light. I tried and they're really terrible. The next thing, you will have to set the EV to +1.0. EV, it's a exposure value, which means that your image will be a little bit brighter than the normal camera will capture. These settings, it's mandatory, because for some reason, if you don't set it up and you leave it at zero, when you capture photographs of the Milky Way, the iPhone somehow removes the background, the sky and the Milky Way, and it will show you only the stars, which is really strange. Here are a couple of examples, as you can see, and for that reason it looks very unnatural, and you will have to set the EV exposure value to 1.0 in order to capture the Milky Way. And there's the third setting. As you notice, it shows me 10 seconds because of the dark skies. Automatic night mode went to 10 seconds exposure, but the moment you will put this on your tripod, this 10 seconds becomes automatically 30 seconds. So imagine 10 seconds it's maximum for handheld photography, but on very dark environments, when you put your camera on the tripod, 10 seconds become 30 seconds, which will allow you for a longer exposure in order to capture that Milky Way. There is one setting which I have missed, and this is actually activating the Apple Pro RAW. If you go to the settings, camera, and go to formats, you can activate Apple Pro RAW. This will allow you to further edit your images much better than JPEG format, which your camera captures. This is only optional for editing. Most of my images are non-edited. Now, while you wait those 30 seconds for the image to be captured, make sure you don't touch the tripod and there is absolutely no wind blowing the tripod, creating any shakes or anything, because that will just make the photograph to be blurry. And something like this is the final image. Your camera take it straight away. And yes, that is Andromeda Galaxy. Thank you very much for watching. And if you found this video useful, please give us a like and maybe a subscribe. And I hope to see you next time with more tutorials and videos like this.